Amazon has now launched the Echo Show 5 in India, a small and reasonably priced smart speaker. It's a lot like the Echo Show, but is available at a much more reasonable 8,999 rupees. The Echo Show 5 has a lot of features that I want to talk about, but let's get started with a feature that I've been using a lot in the past few days.
Before watching this video, please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to be notified when we post new videos.
This feature is called Announcement. And it is a really cool feature that I use to quickly leave a message for family members at home or sometimes to prank my colleagues. This is just one of the many useful features on the Echo Show 5. Like other Echo speakers, the Amazon Echo Show 5 relies on Alexa for its core functionality, and it needs to be plugged into a power source and connected to the internet at all times. You can't use all the features of this device if internet connectivity is unavailable. Let's take a look at what happens when there's no internet.
Alexa.
Sorry, your device is offline. To connect, swipe down from the top of your screen. Then go to Settings, Network.
If you have a stable internet connection, Alexa works well enough, but it struggles to understand us sometimes.
Alexa. What is the distance between Mumbai and Delhi?
At the moment, the Echo Show 5 only supports voice commands in English.
Alexa, who is the Prime Minister of India?
The Prime Minister of India is Narendra Modi.
Here's what happened when we tried to speak to Alexa in Hindi and Gujarati.
Alexa, भारत के प्रधानमंत्री कौन है?
Sorry, I don't know that one.
भारत ना प्रधानमंत्री कौन छे?
Sorry, I don't know that one.
It's important to note that some Alexa skills may allow you to respond in Hindi or other languages, but there's no system-wide support for Indian languages right now.
क्या मैं एक और जोक सुनाऊं?
हाँ.
दोस्तों एक दिन रतन उरा साहब एक शादी में गए.
What else can the Echo Show 5 do? Well, it lets you make a video call, which is nice. Let's check it out. The Echo Show 5 also has a neat feature for privacy. There's a physical switch that covers the camera, and it lets you disable the camera when you are not using it. Unfortunately, the microphone is disabled only via software, so you will have to trust Amazon when the device says the microphone is disabled. There's another neat feature called Drop-In. How does this work? It lets you place a video call from your smartphone to the Echo Show 5, and as long as the device is online, it automatically answers the call. Let's check out how this works. This might sound a bit worrying in terms of privacy, but you can only drop in on your own devices from a smartphone with the Alexa app with your account signed in. You can't just drop in on a stranger's Echo device. And if the camera is switched off on the device, this feature does not work. I used this feature to quickly communicate with my family members when I was away from home. I found it particularly useful when my family members had kept their phones on silent and I needed to speak with them urgently. You can also allow your family members to use the drop-in feature by creating a profile for them on the Alexa app. Since we've been speaking about video-related features, you can play videos using the built-in browser and watch TV shows and movies on Amazon Prime Video. It's not easy to ask the Echo Show 5 to play a video on YouTube, so you'll be restricted to playing these off the browser most of the time. You can use the Alexa app to select and configure lots of skills, as well as control other features on the Amazon Echo Show 5. Some relatively new changes we've seen that utilize the screen include displaying lyrics for some tracks streamed on Amazon Music, and there are various new skills that seem to be focused on making the Echo Show 5 useful and safe for children. Now let's talk about the hardware that the Echo Show 5 packs. The Echo Show 5 is, for a good chunk of the day, a tabletop clock. This is a smart way to use the screen, since the 5.5-inch display is too small to read text across a room. The Amazon Echo Show 5 can be considered a smart display, but is more aptly described as a smart speaker with a screen for additional cues and information. The Echo Show 5 has a 5.5-inch touchscreen and a single 1.65-inch speaker driver for sound. The screen has an 18:9 aspect ratio and a resolution of 960 by 480 pixels. The smaller size makes the Echo Show 5 more convenient for tabletop use. The design is good for basic functions, including serving as a clock, displaying the weather, and providing visual cues such as track name and album art when listening to music. At 5.5 inches, the Echo Show 5 screen is smaller than those on a lot of smartphones today. The touchscreen can be used to control some basic settings on the Amazon Echo Show 5, such as brightness and the Do Not Disturb status. In terms of design, the Echo Show 5 has the same general look and feel as its bigger sibling, with the screen tilted slightly upwards and the back of the device wrapped in fabric. The speaker grille is at the bottom below the screen and fires directly at the surface the Echo Show 5 is placed on. There is rubber for grip at the bottom of the device and three buttons at the top, one to activate or disable the microphones and two to control the volume. There are two microphones at the top of the Echo Show 5 placed between the three buttons. The back of the device has a round power socket for the included adapter, a 3.5mm audio out socket to send audio to a speaker system or headphones, and a micro USB port, which can be used for wired internet connectivity using an appropriate adapter. The sales package of the Amazon Echo Show 5 includes only a power adapter with a fixed 1.5 meter cable, along with the device itself. It relies on Wi-Fi connectivity for its core Alexa and content streaming functions, but you can also connect to devices such as smartphones, tablets, and computers using Bluetooth to play your own music. Finally, let's talk about sound quality. The Amazon Echo Show 5 isn't quite as well equipped as other Echo products when it comes to sound. The device is quite loud, thanks to its bottom firing design, which bounces sound off the surface the speaker is on. The Echo Show 5 isn't as loud as the Google Home, but it is loud enough to be comfortably heard wherever you're sitting, even in a large room. For the best sound imaging, we needed to be seated directly in front of the Echo Show 5. Coming to the actual sound quality, the Echo Show 5 was decent enough for casual listening. Music was slightly tinny with somewhat sharp highs that caused a little bit of sibilance. The low end comes across decent, but the bass is a little bit boomy rather than calculated. Considering that there definitely is space at the back of this device, Amazon should have built a passive radiator into the Echo Show 5 for better low end responses. Music played over Bluetooth sounded similar to stream music, but on the whole, everything sounded a little bit dull at lower volumes. The mid-range was decent, despite the consumer-friendly V-shaped signature. If you're looking to buy a smart speaker and get on the voice assistant bandwagon, the Amazon Echo Show 5 is perhaps the most feature-filled and capable device today that costs less than 10,000 rupees. It combines the benefits of Alexa with both sound and visual feedback, just like the Echo Show, but at a much more affordable price. Although sound quality is average at best, the overall feature set makes this an attractive product. You can buy the Google Home or Amazon Echo Smart Speaker for better sound quality, but you will lose out on the display with both of these products. The Amazon Echo Show 5 opens up the possibility of having a smart display for a lot more people thanks to its reasonable pricing. That was our review of the Amazon Echo Show 5. Thanks for watching, and for all things tech, don't forget to log on to gadgets360.com.